excited because Mitchell and I are about to get our fifth cat, except for Mitchell doesn't know it yet. I'm right outside the meetup location of where I'm gonna, you know, get this rescue cat. His name is Dan. It's a little bit of a story of how we're getting him and how it's a surprise for Mitchell, but also a little bit not a surprise. So what had happened is that Mitchell was here at this PetSmart a week ago. No, it was like a little less than a week ago. It was last Sunday and today's Friday. And he saw this cat, you know, they had these like a rescue shelter here, like, you know, outside the PetSmart where they could like tug on your heartstrings, get you to adopt a cat, you know, on the way in and out of the pet store. And he saw this cat that looked just like our cat Ash and our other cat Felix. And he sent me a picture, which was stupid if he didn't want another cat. Cause if I see a cat that I like, I kind of got to get it. I came as soon as I could. I was grocery shopping. So I came right after grocery shopping. They were already gone because like they were only here for a little bit, only over the weekend. But he said, you know, maybe message them. Maybe we'll get them. Let's see. And I have been messaging them all week and he didn't know that. He knew a tiny bit, but I was like, oh, they only go on the weekends and only some weekends. He was like, okay, well, maybe we'll see him again. And the whole time I'm like, no, I have plans to pick him up on Friday and he doesn't know. So here I am at the store and I'm about to meet him. We had plans to pick him up at 6. I asked him if they could do earlier because I got off work a little earlier, but they were like, oh no, the foster parents can't. But then last minute, they were like, oh, we know it's last minute, but could you meet at 5:15, 5:30 instead? And I said, I'm on my way. So I'm here and it's 5:09. I really wanted to go inside and get a few things for the cat first, but I don't know if I have enough time. If it's 5:15 when he's here, I don't really have enough time, but if it's the 5:30, then I could. So I might just go inside, risk being a little bit late. I think he would understand. Because also the adoption counselor won't be here until 5:30, so I think it'd be okay. So I'm gonna go inside and get some new things for Dan. Mitchell's making Dan and me wait in this long line for a grilled cheese. Right, Dan? Okay, so Dan and I are in the car right now. Outside of Zaxby's, we're waiting for Mitchell's food because part of my ruse, oh, my thumb. part of my ruse to come get the cat without Mitchell knowing, you know, because like usually I don't like leave the house randomly without telling him. I was definitely just caught filming myself, which is fun. But part of my ruse to come get the cat and leave the house without Mitchell being like, where are you going? Is I said I was gonna go get Chipotle and I did not. But Mitchell was like, oh, go get me something. So I just got him some Zaxby's and now I'm officially on my way and we're gonna surprise Mitchell. Hey Mitchell. Okay, so Mitchell was downstairs with Tito and he's coming up now because he thinks he has food here.
Hey, I didn't allow this.
Mitchell, hurry up. Dan wants to meet you.
Are you hungry?
Yeah.
Good.
I wanted to go in. Why do we got the handsome Dan? Oh, hey, buddy. Why do we got handsome Dan? Is that why you want to go Chipotle?
Yeah,
did you even get Chipotle?
No.
Oh, you are built on lies. Yeah.
They said, be careful, let them not run the other cats yet, you know. Yeah. You have to transition it, but you can say, hey.
Hey, handsome.
That's his first name.
Handsome.
His middle name's Dan.
First name, handsome. Second name, Dan.
What did he grab?
He was like that when I first met him, but he cozied up real fast.
Where's my food? Can I get food?
Yeah, you did. It's in the car, but he was priority number one. Oh, he wants some french fries. Yay. Or some grilled cheese. Oh, yeah, he into the grilled cheese, babe.
Hey. Oh, yeah, he wants that.
Don't give it to him. Hey, those are Dan's toys. I'm trying to make him feel welcomed. Mish, not you too. Oh, okay, Dan. All right, time to get out. Mitchell, so you can let him out since I was, you know, the one to get him. Yeah, he's bigger than I thought from the photo you sent me.
Hey, Dan.
Just be slow and gentle.
So, do we get this carrier too?
Yeah, because they said the foster parents got him with the carrier. So, the foster mom was like, take it. Just let him be slow. He was like this when I first met him, even around the foster family. They were like, he warms up best.
Hey, Dan.
Dan, we met earlier. Hi.
Where are you going?
All right, so Handsome Dan is hiding under some furniture right now.
The treadmill.
Yeah, the treadmill specifically. So we'll have to check for that anytime we go to use it, because that'd not be good. Did they tell you when you saw Handsome Dan, like how they found him, mm-hmm. or like how he was rescued? Okay, the foster parents told me. They said someone who lives like in an apartment complex brought him in because she went outside to throw out her trash and she saw this plastic bag moving. Someone had put him in the plastic bag with litter and stapled it. I know. They like almost made me cry in the story. I know. So that's his story. And then they said they're not sure if he was abused before, because like they went to pet him, mm-hmm. and like them putting their hand like this made him hiss, even though he was like totally calm a second before then. So they're not sure. Like they said, sometimes that's a sign of, you know, past abuse. So they said, you know, be slow and patient with him while he gets acclimated to us.
Poor Dan.
No.
Yeah, he's so cute though.
Yeah. But the rescue people were super, super nice.
Yeah.
So. Okay, I got some items for Dan while at the pet store, so I figured I'd do a cat haul, you know. This is, I think, the only toy I bought him, because our cats already have a ton of toys, a lot of which are new, so like, he'll be fine using them because they don't smell like cat too much. The foster parent said he has one of these that he loves. So of course, I got him one. This one's like Christmas themed,
So limited edition for our cat. This bag of food, they gave me for free since I rescued a cat. Came in like a coupon book from the pet store. They said he currently eats this already, so it'll be good to help transition into the food that we already feed our current cats so he doesn't get an upset tummy. And they also feed him this wet food. Again, we're just gonna use this for a little bit until he can get slowly onto the diet that our cats eat. And of course we got catnip. This is mostly for our current cats. I don't know if he likes catnip. I actually didn't ask the foster parents that. This will help calm down Connor, Felix, Ash, and Misty so that hopefully they are good cat siblings. And this is the cat carrier that he came in. The owners gave me like a towel that has the owners. Where are the owners? The foster parents gave me a towel that has their scent on it so we can help like, you know, transition to our home. And the cat carrier, I actually bought a second cat carrier that matches the cat carriers that our cats currently use. But if he ends up liking the soft one more, that's what we'll continue to use. And whichever one we don't end up keeping, we'll probably donate back to foster pots. So that another cat and foster parent and future cat owner could use that one.
So are you happy to have Handsome Dan?
He's hiding from me. Yeah. And growling.
But are you happy?
He hates me.
Mitchell.
I picked him out.
Yeah. But were you surprised?
Yeah, I was definitely surprised.
Was it a good surprise?
Yeah, I definitely like him. I mean, I picked him out. I saw him in PetSmart.
Yeah.
And then when I saw him, you know, I snapped her a picture of it. And yeah.
Big mistake.
I know.
Huge.
I was like, ooh, we got to get him. But then I was like, you know, do we really need another cat? And next thing you know, Sarah went to Chipotle, came home with a cat. So. He is here to stay, and I love him, and we're going to give him a good home.
Girl!
Hey, wait, come here. Earlier, when my phone went off, and you were like, what was that? And I was like, because it was my Facebook Messenger sound, and it was the foster paws.
Hey, you're filming.
Yeah, I know, I'm telling you that I got you, because you were like, what was that noise? And I said, oh, an email.
Nothing.
Yeah, I sent an email, and you were like, oh, was it so-and-so?
Oh, yeah.
I was like, yeah, it was so-and-so, actually. But it wasn't. It was them saying, hey, can you come get it?
Yeah,
because
I had an email, too.
Yeah,
and so
I know.
I checked.
Yeah. No, that's why I said it was email, because I get the same email, so mm-hmm. I knew you knew we did get an email.
Mm-hmm.
But definitely wasn't my email, you know, ding, or whatever.
It was like, ding, Dan's ready.
Yeah.